Hi guys, this is Mike Elf from the Comic Book Syndicate. We just got finished watching Deadpool 2 starring Ryan Reynolds. And I'd like to know what everybody thought, starting over here with Jolie. What are your initial feelings about this movie?
Oh, what a nostalgia trip. Hooray! They took everything you could possibly love, ironically ever, and crammed it into this movie and made brilliant comedy out of it.
Yeah, exactly that. Like, if you loved the first one, this one was just...
Yeah.
The first one did well, so we can do even better. And like... It didn't even look that much more impressive. The CG was still obviously bad, and I think on purpose at points. The sets were still small for the most part. It was still a small movie when you think about it. And man, you shove such big personalities in there, it doesn't feel small at all.
No, like, great.
Everyone was great. Everyone was on par. The humor was there for sure. Like, the jokes were on point. The physical comedy was really there. The gags, like just like traditional old school comedy mixed with some new stuff. It was great.
Okay, we have a special guest today, a new face. This is Danielle. Danielle, what did you think of Deadpool 2?
Well, you always worry when they make a sequel that it's not going to live up to it or it's just going to be terrible, but it surpasses and or just stands up to the first one. Like, totally different, but in a really good way. And so it was awesome.
I was worried because Disney was close to buying Fox, and I thought they would change it, but they haven't bought them yet. I was also worried because they changed directors. There was a brief part in the movie, like maybe 20, 30 minutes in, where it started to slow down a little bit. It was almost melodramatic and sappy. It stopped being funny. Like when they were in jail for a while, I was like, oh no, it's not going to be as funny. But then the rest of the movie was nonstop laughing. And it was such a good satire of other superhero movies, of other movies, of Ryan Reynolds, some of his misfires.
I don't know. Some things really threw me off for a loop. Some things that I were really excited about in the trailer ended up not paying off at all. And while it was at the moment of setting, I was like, nah, forget it. Like, it was just a joy the whole time. As a member of the LGBTQ community, glad that there's finally some gay superheroes, but I mean, they're like in like 20 minutes of the movie, so maybe next time more, please.
I mean, they've obviously changed Cable's backstory. First of all, Cable's backstory in the comic is completely convoluted and changes every time a new writer takes
Welcome
it on.
Welcome to the X-Men.
Yeah. And also, I didn't know this until today when I watched the trailer. I didn't know that all these characters from X-Force were going to be in it. So let's briefly touch on the fact that they introduce Bedlam.
Gotta love Terry Crews.
Shatterstar.
Oh, I love Shatterstar.
And he looks... Well, he looks workable. He looks okay.
Yeah.
Everyone's favorite character, Peter.
Peter.
Any power you want to tell us about?
I don't have one. I just saw the ad.
You're in.
Oh, Domino. Domino was great. So good.
She needs her own. I would watch a Domino movie of her just like tiptoeing and skipping through the destruction happening around her. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Like, Deadpool has a line in there where he's like, oh, how can you make Lux cinematic? And man, did they have so much fun with her character. Mm-hmm. And it was mm-hmm. so refreshing to see a character whose powers are so far from the norm, and it just has an attitude that's so different from all like the grim, broody, right. like serious superheroes that we have. Even Deadpool gets like really violent and a lot and like yeah. goofy and stuff like that. But you have Domino, who's so different from everyone. I loved her. I loved her so much. I loved her outfit. I love her attitude. I love the actress. I love everything.
Yeah, I agree. There's one character we're all forgetting.
Oh, right. Oh,
Dupinder.
Dupinder. Dupinder. Star of the movie.
Brown Panther.
I will watch a movie just with Dupinder, please. He's so funny.
I was really surprised that they still included him.
He must have, like, done so well in the first one that they were like, well, obviously, let's bring him back and give him a bigger role. Because yeah. I do remember the first one. He was so funny. Yeah, it's interesting how it did kind of a similar thing to Guardians, where it meshed, like, the keeping a plot of mm-hmm. a movie for everyone to see and then having the little tidbits of Easter eggs for, like, comic book fans and stuff like that.
Right.
Whereas, like, in Guardians, you had the whole collector's room full of garbage that the regular person doesn't need to know anything about. But then, like, you and I are like, oh, Cosmo was there. Like,
right.
in this one, it was like, oh, they made, like, subtle references to, like, oh, Black Tom Cassidy mm-hmm. was in there. And then they made, like, references to Deadpool's X-Force costume, which was really cool. And, like, the little yes. things about, like, Juggernaut being Xavier's half-brother. Like, something that, like, mm-hmm. we would know about but doesn't matter at all. And, like, is just, like, background noise basically to the average viewer.
It enhances it for you guys.
Yeah, it gives, like, a little thing that's like, oh, we understand that you've been a fan of this for a lot longer. So here's, like, a dog treat. Just throw it at me. I'm like, thank you.
There was something for those people, and there's also something for people who are just following those movies. Because at one point, I think he climbs on top of Juggernaut and is like, sun's getting real little big guy. And I'm like, oh, okay.
There are references to the other superhero movies that Deadpool's been able to make in the last couple years since the first one.
Yeah, it's like they wrote that film and they said, I think there are too many references to the other films. Better add 50 more. Yeah. Like, it was pretty good.
What's dumb about superhero movies? Let's reference that. Like, the Martha bit, the sun's getting real low.
Right.
There was a bunch of them in there, but it was just like, it was good. And it was like, again, stuff that's funny if you've seen all these other movies. And then it's like stuff that is like kind of funny still on its own if you haven't. And there's other stuff that's just funny in general. And there's like references to not just nerdy stuff. There's like the aha reference that you guys got and all that kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. And all of like the old school stuff like that Deadpool's really known for. So it's like his love for Bay Arthur.
Yeah, and I feel like where other movies put all of that stuff in and it becomes garbage, it was in this movie and it all served the plot. Like, even the Celine Dion song at the start, like, oddly served the plot. So you can't hate this movie.
Anyone who hates this movie is an asshole. Okay.
But they just don't get it.
It's like an ugly baby. You still gotta kiss it, feed it.
Speaking of ugly babies.
What? So here's my thing. If Disney ever ended up buying 20th Century Fox, could Disney make a movie like this?
Here's the thing. If they don't, Ryan Reynolds will walk, right? So we won't have to worry about it, I think. And then, could you imagine Disney trying to make a Deadpool movie without Ryan Reynolds?
No one would go see it. It wouldn't work.
Exactly. So I'm not too worried about that on this front, especially because Disney, number one, loves money.
Well, I was going to say, ultimately, they want money.
Yeah.
And this has proved that an R-rated movie can rake in a ton of money.
Yeah, and they might open up a whole other studio devoted to that kind of thing.
Yeah, but if we can get another couple Logans out of it.
That's the thing, is that there's this movement of people who are, you know, bring X-Men back to Marvel. Why? Fox is, granted, there's a lot of crappy Fox X-Men movies, but the last few, like, Days of Future Past was great, Logan was great, Deadpool was great.
Apocalypse.
I didn't know, it was terrible.
Yeah, but the last 4 out of 5 have been really good, so,
just and then the most recent.
New Mutants looks good, so I think right now X-Men is in safer hands at Fox than it would be at Disney. Go and see it, just as good as Deadpool 1. I'm looking forward to more. I hope they keep, you know, the exact same formula going. You know, Ryan
Change
Reynolds.
Change it up a little.
Well, you know what I mean? When I say formula, I mean keep it good. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
I would say I like this one more than the first one.
I could agree with that.
I'd have to see it again and then to make that determination.
Yeah. And this movie's also proof, speaking of the soundtrack, that you don't have to have shitty music on your soundtrack just because that shitty music is popular.
Right.
Like they did with Chad Kroeger in Spider-Man 1 with Hero.
Yeah. Dude, I was like really into that song in high school.
It meant a lot to me.
Yeah, it was like, that song was for some people.
I feel like that was the catalyst for why Nickelback might be slightly popular with people, and that's
No, it definitely
wrong.
Was.
That we if I could go back in time.
There you go.
If I could get the thing from...
There you go. If you could go back in time...
The time slider?
What would you do?
From whatever that... Yeah, I would make that Nickelback never happened.
There you go. I'm going to agree with you. I'll help you
that's
do
what
that.
I would do, yeah.
No Nickelback.
Out of
no Nickelback.
Everything going on right now, you guys are mad about Nickelback. It's 2018. You're still mad about Nickelback?
Yeah. I'm still mad. Yeah.
Yeah. I feel like we
specifically
go back to
about the song "Hero" by Chad Kroeger.
I would go back and tell Avril Lavigne that Chad Kroeger is going to give her Lyme disease and to stay away from.
Did that actually happen?
She got Lyme disease, but not from him. I don't know. Okay. Can you get Lyme disease from a human?
I don't know.
Unless he took her rolling around the forest and he gave her the tick. I don't know, but they probably did.
Watch out for ticks. That's your life lesson.
And Chad Kroeger, apparently.
There you
in
go.
In the forest,
he'll give you Lyme
around.
Disease.
We're tired.
This is going off the rails.